The NFL is America's game. It brings cities together, it brings families together. It has long-standing, rich traditions that people hold very dear.
It's NFL Total Access on a night where Jacksonville gets into the win column.
We have a game that is enjoyed by many people, everyone from the casual fan to the die-hard fan. Those that don't know the game very well and are looking to learn more, and those that love to dive into numbers and schematics on a weekly basis.
We'll start with the running backs.
People love to compare athletes and compare teammates or opponents on the field for debate about the fastest players in the NFL or the best players in the NFL.
If you look at a score sheet from 1920, there are statistics that are captured. It's pretty minimal. It was maybe who scored on a touchdown, how many passes were thrown. And over the decades, more stats have been added.
You're going to start on the 12 Mahomes?
We could see things now, distance traveled, speed, miles per hour, that we could never see in the 1990s, 1980s, 1970s.
In working with AWS, we found we can use this data to better educate our players, our coaches, our fans. As we're able to create more stats, it allows us to see how much of a chess game this NFL game really is.
The offensive line on the right side, they're being pushed a lot, and that might be the reason why, you know, Russell Wilson's scrambling out.
When bringing about change and disruption, there's the wrecking ball approach where you really tear everything down.
Having Russell Wilson being out of this tackle box, forcing him out of the pocket.
But in an organization like the NFL that's steeped in history, and frankly has been super successful with that history, begs the question why. We're always striving to get better, and technology presented a real opportunity for that.
Technology has always been a big part of the NFL, dating back to when we first put radios in helmets so coaches could talk to quarterbacks, and all the way through the decades of instant replay.
Fast forward till today, and now we have big debates about we collect all this data on all our players using computing horsepower from AWS. How do we use that?
The NFL's next-gen stats platform is changing the game.
The real big disruption was starting to realize that, hey, you know, the people in football operations really could benefit from interesting data and information.
How fast is Russell Wilson's time to throw?
So actually, he has a time to throw of 2.26 seconds. It's the fastest in the league.
Next-gen stats has been around in the NFL for a couple years.
I think that's much faster than previous years.
And I feel like we're one of the first teams to really to embrace it.
The foundation of next-gen stats is really player tracking.
Every player has a microchip inside of their shoulder pads that's tracking every bit of their movement.
When the ball is snapped, we're collecting data off of all the players as well as a tracking device in the ball. In the stadium, numerous antennas triangulate where that player is located. And we generate over 200 stats in real time after each play. All the data we collect goes back to our clubs so they can use that for their game day or weekly analysis.
This gives us a much better context because now we can for surely see that this player came from point B.
We have always had a lot of information from the NFL as far as how the play began and how the play ended.
We can see exactly how this guy got to all of these targets.
What we're getting now is a lot of the information in between.
Take Russell Wilson from the Seahawks, for example. He's known to be a quarterback that scrambles a lot.
So this is a 3D rendering of Russell Wilson throwing a deep touchdown pass down the right sideline. And then we can animate through it, and then we see the end of the route.
Now we're able to actually quantify that. How often does he scramble? How far does he scramble? How well does he throw the ball when he's on the run?
This was the stat we were talking about on the way down. It's completion percentage versus expected completion percentage.
Are these only in man coverage, or like
no,
what if they're...
There's a little bit of a race from every team to try to come up with the most useful information. Things that our coaches can apply to their regular game plan, maybe point out some things that they would not be able to see just from watching film.
The best coaches will always be the best coaches. Computers and machine learning isn't meant to replace intuition. It's really meant to augment and help even take it to the next level. We've been able to apply new technologies with AWS that use machine learning at its core to help keep our players healthy and safe.
It's really important to know what's happening to the players. And if you know what's going to happen to the players, then you have the ability to react.
At the league, our team started with some very smart engineers, but they didn't necessarily have all of the data science expertise. In working with AWS, we were able to grow that skill set. For example, finding the probability of a pass being complete is not something that you can easily do when you're just writing a formula. With the introduction of machine learning, we were able to learn that the probability of a pass being completed was really based on a number of metrics. At the time the ball is snapped, the quarterback drops back and he's assessing the field. At that point, we're measuring the distance to every defender from the quarterback to see how much space he actually has to make that pass. We then assess the distance between every wide receiver to their nearest defender and how much room they have on the field in order for a pass to be completed to them. We're actually able to calculate how many yards we would expect them to gain after that catch. This is great because then we can see who is actually making plays on that improvisation after catching the ball versus those that are hitting the expectation. We didn't know how much these things mattered until the machine learning exercise actually taught us.
Five to purple, four to purple, three, two, five. Content is everything, and the story is everything.
Scott got shut you for you.
Oh, let's go, Daniel.
Our announcers, the more they know that can get generated by stats, the better prepared they are to tell intriguing stories about our players.
There was a Monday night football game where one of the best wide receivers in the game broke out into the open field and outran three defensive backs. NextGen immediately was able to tell us he traveled 21.7 miles per hour, which some people would say, okay, yeah, he was fast on the field. What does that mean? If you ran a 40-yard dash at 21.7 miles per hour, that 40-yard dash would be 3.77 seconds. And the more we get familiar with miles per hour, the more fans are going to be able to tell, wow, this guy's a little bit faster than this guy, or this guy on this play went faster than this guy.
Welcome back to NFL Fantasy Live, presented by...
Our stats are a real connection to our fans.
Like 60% of the snaps are being through.
Seeing how fantasy football has evolved over the years is a great example. If you play fantasy, you're keeping an eye on the stats of your players. And so I think it continues to be part of our story, and the more we augment our story with the facts of the game, the better it gets for our fans. The way data is consumed is changing the way people live, and that's what's really amazing to me.
I think when we look on where we are now in the NFL, you've got this intersection of big data and the ability to compute at large scale.
All of those things come to life on any given Sunday, and that's what's pretty cool about watching it happen real time.
Part of our work with AWS is going to be getting our data in a way that sets us up for the future. They've given us some great tools to start with, and from there it's our job to take it and run with it.
All the highlights coming up from Thursday Night Football.
We're making a big impact here on how the game can be consumed and how fans can better understand the game, and it's just amazing to be a part of that.